Hello, I'm Mr. Aditya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Nanak was a Satguru and not a Guru. Anybody who addresses Nanak as a Guru Nanak, he is demoting him, he is degrading him, dishonoring him. So you can see, a Sikh is to be found one in a million and two in maybe many millions. So as a true in Christianity, Christ is found one in a thousand and two in 10,000. I'm not a Christian, I'm a Christ. And Christ is a noun, Christian is an adjective. Christians are people of the book. And here I'm rendering exposition of St. Matthew 21, verse 33 to 46. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Pabram, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, according to St. Matthew 21, verse 33 to 43 and 45 to 46. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, hear another parable. This is the last parable Jesus delivered in the temple. And it is about this temple itself, which was the University of Theology. And that is coining the moral laws, which is the old wine. Or that's wine press it was, you know. Here another parable. There was a landowner, Yahweh. All this land belonged to Yahweh. Who planted a vineyard, the temple, to worship Elohim. Elohim is the one, the temple of Elohim was one which has a curtain around it. And the open space where they were doing trading and other things, is it turned the table, that belonged to Yahweh. So to worship Elohim and Yahweh in the outer court. Put a hedge around it. That means it's a separate from the secular world. It is ecclesiastical world, temple place, beyond the secular authority as today the churches and other religious places are. You know, the policeman can't enter or catch a person if he enter the church because he's gone to another world, which is a classical world, not secular. Dug a wine press, establish a school of theology to coin the moral laws in it, and built a tower as a symbol of, you know, of the school of theology to coin the moral laws in it. And built a tower as a symbol, as today the churches have spires. Then he leased it to tenants, the priest of Moses, especially of Levi tribe, the lawgiver, and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants, the prophets, the whipmasters of the rabbis. They are prophets or whipmasters, you know, and they see that the rabbis is they are working properly. We must the rabbi to the tenants, the priest, you know, temple priest, to obtain his produce. With master is a separate word. To obtain his produce means good quality old wine. The moral law should not be altered or corrupted. But they corrupted it as in Genesis 17 on circumcision. Circumcision was the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only. And the sons of Isaac are to be circumcised. But these temple priests, they were making Jew outwardly. And over there, anybody, Gentile or a slave or anything, to make him a Jew, they will circumcise him and put a millstone of ritual around his neck. So they were making fake sons of Abraham or fake sons of Isaac through circumcision. And today you see these white Jews, which are Russians and all those, you know, and they become Jew of physical body through circumcision. So they have adopted Isaac as their forefather, whereas Isaac was of Semitic race, not of Aryan race. So by renouncing their own father, tribal father, and adopting somebody else's tribal father, they became super bastard, unfaithful to their own tribal fathers. So they break their covenant with Abraham, sorry, with Yahweh. Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, they are the lords of the nature. But the tenants, the priest, seize the servant, the prophets, and one they beat, another they killed, John the Baptist, and a third angel Stephen, they stoned him to death. Again he sent other servants, the sons of Abraham, as they were prepared by John the Baptist, the builders who built the temple for the worship of Yahweh, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. These crook temple high priests and his stooges, that the builders, sons of Abraham, had rejected. Became the cornerstones. They became the, you know, the owner of the temple, whereas the temple belonged to the Yahweh's priest, which was Prophet Elijah. John the Baptist was the proper cornerstone. They threw him out and they occupied it, which was the super pastors. The rightful cornerstone was John the Baptist, who was thrown out of the temple. Finally, he and Elohim, who is the master of all, whose temple was holiest of holy, with curtain around it, sent his own son, Christ Jesus, to them, thinking they will honor and not respect, you know, as it's written in the Bible, my son. But when the tenants, the temple priests saw the son, they said to one another, or colluded with each other, this is the heir of the whole complex of Yahweh and Elohim. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance. They seized him, beat him to their heart's content, threw him out of the vineyard. And vineyard means the temple, and killed him on the cross with other criminals. What will the owner, Elohim and Yahweh of the vineyard, do to those tenants, the temple priests, when he comes? They answered him, he will put those wretched men to a wretched death, as it happened in 70 AD, and lease his vineyard to other tenants who will give him the product, who will give him the produce at the proper times. Jesus said to them, did you never read in the scriptures, the stone, the crook, temple priest, temple high priest, that the builders, sons of Abraham, salt of the earth, rejected, has become the cornerstone by the Lord of darkness in Yahweh? Has this been done? It is wonderful in our eyes that most people have forgotten their tribal fathers. Never mind our supernatural father, Elohim. So if you don't know your just father, how will you know the supernatural father? First know natural, then your supernatural will be known to you. First know what you see with your two naked eye, and what is not seen will be known to you. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of heaven, kingdom of heaven is seen in law and order, which is outside, and not the royal kingdom of God that is within our own heart here, will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit. That is why hell prevailed when the temple was destroyed forever in 70 AD. The saltless people, unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, were thrown out of the promised land to suffer holocaust at the hands of sons of man, the Gentile. When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard his parables, they knew that he was speaking about them. That is, they were twice born psychic groups, psychic people, you know, of the order of Judah Iscariot, who was seeking the praises of men, not glorifying our Father as those who are sealed to serve God do. And although they were attempting to arrest him, they feared the crowd, for they regarded him as the Messiah and not a prophet. Messiah is different from prophet. Messiah is greater than prophet. For Messiah is the very son of Elohim, while the prophet is son of Yahweh, the potter. So there are corruptions in the Bible and gospel. That's why gospel gets written over your heart and you can't get it written in ink on paper. Gospel, you receive it through logical reasoning. If you are not capable of logical reasoning, you can't have it.